guys are so totally more honest than first service. You're a first grader? Awesome, awesome. So when you feel that way, when you feel that way and you see that person coming, what do you want to do? Oh, just can't even be in the room with them sometimes, right? You're so angry. Yeah. You ask them if they want a red nose. Oh my goodness. Well, what do you think Jesus did when all of his disciples ran away and they left him to be killed on the cross? How mad do you think he was? You think? Well, here's what Pastor Steve read. What Pastor Steve read was a story of Jesus after he had died, and then after he died, he raised up from the dead, right, and became alive, and his disciples saw him and thought he was a ghost. They said, oh, crud, we're being haunted. No. He says, look, see, my body's real. He says, anybody have something to eat? I'll show you I'm real. And he ate some fish. And then the disciples went, oh, crud, he's back. And we left him at the cross, didn't we? Crud? No. Junk. Oh, poo. Oh, poo. Oh, stinkers. Now we're in trouble because we left Jesus at the cross when he was at his worst moment, when he was dying. And you think he's going to be mad at us? Do you remember what Pastor Steve read? We would be, but Jesus was not. He says, he didn't say this in the story that Pastor Steve read, but we know that in Luke he does say, forgive them, for they don't know what they're doing. So Jesus forgave them even before he died. He forgave them. He forgave all the disciples. He forgave all the people who hurt him, who could really have made him mad, but he forgave them instead. And then he said to his disciples, let me explain to you why this all happened, why all these, what looks like bad stuff happened. And he talked about the scriptures, and he talked about what God was doing. And he said, I forgave you. And they said, we're sorry, Jesus. Now that it's not written there, but don't you imagine they felt bad? Don't you imagine they said they were sorry to Jesus? And Jesus said, it's all forgiven. So here's what you need to do. You ready? He said, I went through all of this so that God's forgiveness and repentance could be proclaimed to all the nations. So remember, disciples, followers of Jesus, that Jesus forgives us, and we need to forgive others. And we need to say when we're sorry, even as we forgive other people for when they hurt us. Even like Jesus forgave us. So we proclaim, we declare, we tell the world about God's love and forgiveness when we practice that too. And we forgive those people we get mad at. May not like them, but that's okay. We can forgive them, right? And we can say we're sorry when we mess up, right? So that other people can forgive us. And that's the way God's love is seen. Okay, so the next time you get really, really, really mad, you know what? You might want to count to 10.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Woo!
And if you're really, really mad, you might have to want to count to 100, but not now. Give yourself time to calm down, and then forgive them for hurting you. Can you do that? You may not have to hang around them anymore, but forgive them for hurting you so that we can be forgiven too. All right? When did I lose it? Let's pray. Quick, let's pray. Oh, Lord Jesus.
Oh, Lord Jesus.
Help me as I count to 100.
Help me as I count to 100.
Help us all as we get angry.
Help us all as we get angry.
And mad.
And
we want to get even when
someone hurts us.
Help us, Lord,
help us, Lord,
to forgive them.
Forgive them.
like you,
have
forgiven us.
Help us to admit
when we are wrong,
so that others
may forgive us too.
Help us show your love
in everything we say,
and most importantly,
by what we do. It's in your name we pray.